consider a particle of mass m moves in a spherical bowl, which is given by the equation z is equal to half a into x square plus y square. A is a constant. Now find the Lagrangian of the system. Also obtain the equations of motion. So this is a problem. Now let us solve this problem. Now let us first draw the diagram corresponding to this equation. Here this is a spherical bowl. So this is a spherical bowl we have drawn. And the mass m is kept inside the bowl. Now let us fix the coordinate of this bowl. This coordinate is x comma y comma z, where what is z? Z is given by half a into x square plus y square. Now this problem can be solved by a spherical polar coordinates. Since this curved surface, we cannot solve this problem by using Cartesian coordinates. So since it is a spherical surface, now we are choosing the point and the mass is at this point, and from here you draw a perpendicular to the z axis. So this is your z and this is your z, and from here you make a projection on both the x and y axis. So on the x axis as well as the y axis. Now let theta be phi be the angle between the rho. So you may assume this is a rho direction. So the angle between rho and the x we call this as phi. So the x coordinate is rho cos phi, and the y coordinate. So this is y. So this y coordinate is rho sin phi. Therefore, and your z is z. So this equation z is given as half a into x square plus y square. Once if we substitute for x and y in this equation, this becomes half a into a rho square, where rho square is x square plus y square. So the coordinates of this point in spherical polar, in cylindrical coordinate system is rho, phi and z. Now what is the kinetic energy of this particle? Kinetic energy of the particle in rectangular coordinate system is half m into x dot square plus y dot square plus z dot square. Now since x is known, x dot can be determined. Y is also rho sin phi, so y dot is also, that can be determined. So find x dot square and y dot square, and if you substitute, you will get the expression for the kinetic energy. Z is given, so this is z. So z dot can be also, if you differentiate this one, z dot can be also obtained. Now you substitute x dot, y dot, z dot in this expression. Finally, you will get the expression for the kinetic energy, which is half m, the rho dot square plus rho square phi dot square plus a square rho square rho dot square. So you will get the expression for the kinetic energy. Here there are two coordinates, rho and phi, two independent coordinates, because this system is having 2 degrees of freedom. So there are two independent coordinates, rho and phi. So the expression for t is half m into this is because z is equal to half a rho square. This is given. So the t expression will be, expression for t is half m into a square rho square plus 1 into rho dot square plus rho square phi dot square. So once you substitute z dot here and you simplify, you will get the expression for the kinetic energy. So this is the expression for the kinetic energy. Now what is the expression for the potential energy? Which is mg in h. H is your z distance. Mg z. And z is given. This value. So mg a into x square plus y square by 2. This is, you can substitute for z from this given equation, then x square plus y square is your rho square. So this is rho square. So you substitute here, you will get expression for v. So v can be also expressed in terms of the coordinate rho, mg a rho square by 2. So the kinetic expression for kinetic energy is known, expression for potential is known, both are expressed in terms of the coordinate rho and phi. Now what is Lagrangian? The expression for Lagrangian is L is equal to T minus V. So T minus V, T is the kinetic energy, V is the potential energy. You substitute the expression for T from the previous expression, and you substitute the expression for V in the previous expression. So you substitute T and V, you will get this expression reduces to half M into A square rho square plus 1 into rho dot square plus rho square phi dot square minus mga rho square divided by 2. Now let us write down the equation of motion. The equation and the Lagrangian equation of motion is d by dt of partial dl by d rho dot minus dl by d rho is equal to 0, because this is the only equation with respect to the generalized coordinate rho. Now since L is available, you find a d by dl by d rho dot, which is equal to m into a square rho square plus 1 into rho dot, and again you differentiate, you will get the first expression d by dt of partial dl by d rho dot. So if we differentiate, this expression is m into rho dot into a square rho square plus 1 plus rho dot into 2 a square rho rho dot. So you will get this expression. And if you simplify this one, this reduces to m rho double dot into a square rho square plus 1 plus 2 m rho dot square a square rho. So you will get the expression. Now the second expression is partial dl by d rho. You have to find partial dl by d rho. Again, you know the expression for L. If you differentiate with respect to rho, this expression is half m into rho dot square a square into 2 rho plus 2 rho phi dot square minus mg a rho. So you will get this expression. So if you differentiate L, so here is your L. L is there. So if you differentiate L with respect to rho, you will get this expression. Now let us write down the equation of motion. The equation of motion is, you substitute this expression dl by dt of partial dl by d rho dot. So this expression is available. Partial dl by d rho, this is also, that is we have calculated. You substitute these two expressions, you will get m rho double dot into a square rho square plus 1 plus 2 m rho dot square a square rho minus n by 2 rho dot square a square 2 rho plus 2 rho phi dot square plus mg a rho. So you can, the common term m can be removed. So that equation becomes rho double dot into a square rho square plus 1 plus a square rho rho dot minus rho phi dot square plus g a rho is equal to 0. So this is one of the Lagrangian equation of motion, and for the, if we use the generalized coordinate rho. Now similarly, since this problem is having two coordinates, so rho and phi, we can write down the Lagrangian equation of motion for the generalized coordinate phi also. So d by dt of partial dl by d phi dot minus partial dl by d phi is equal to 0, and dl by d phi dot, because you know the expression for L, L is already known. So you take this L and you find partial dl by d phi dot, we find this is equal to m rho square phi dot. And if we differentiate with respect to time, d by dt of partial d by d rho dot, this is equal to m rho square phi dot plus 2 m rho phi dot. So you differentiate, so the phi dot becomes phi double dot, and you keep m phi dot constant, you have to differentiate to rho square, you will get 2 m rho phi dot. So you know this expression. And from the expression for L, if we differentiate with respect to phi, this is 0, because expression for L is independent of phi. Therefore, partial dl by d phi is equal to 0. You substitute this in this, your Lagrangian equation of motion. So in the equation, if you substitute, you will get m rho square phi dot plus 2 m rho rho dot phi dot is equal to 0, m can be removed because it's a common term. Rho square phi dot plus 2 rho rho dot phi dot is equal to 0, equation 2. So equation 1 and equation 2 both are equation of motion corresponding to this problem. Because one corresponding to the coordinate rho, the another corresponding to the coordinate phi. So the idea is first the starting point is first you have to choose which coordinate in the problem must be solved. Since it is a curved surface, it is not possible to solve it using a rectangular coordinate. So here you have to choose a cylindrical coordinate. So using a cylindrical coordinate, the expression for kinetic energy as well as the potential energy must be expressed. Then write down the Lagrangian. Once the Lagrangian is available, you can obtain the equation of motion corresponding to the two generalized coordinates.